Hello everyone, welcome to the Tristar Gym channel. Today's episode, we are looking at how to prevent the guard pass by using the inverted triangle threat. Okay, the inverted triangle threat is a very powerful move. It stops pressure passing and also it can finish your opponent. Like you see Braulio Estima here, finishing his opponent Andre Galvao in the 2009 Abu Dhabi final. When you're playing butterfly guard and somebody's on top of you putting pressure, trying to smash your butterfly guard, trying to pin you, a great option is to switch your hooks and threaten the inverted guard, the inverted triangle. When I threaten the inverted guard, the inverted triangle, my opponent should give up the guard pass, or you know, get stuck in this really dangerous hold here. Now, for when I get this inverted triangle, I usually like to prop up to my arm and elbow, and then arm, and then sweep my opponent over. We'll go over the sweep as well, but before the sweep, let's talk about how we set this move up. Now, when I'm in double knee shield, here I have my feet on my opponent's hip, I have my knees in my opponent's chest, I have both his wrists. We call this guard the double knee shield. When I'm here, there's not much I can do in terms of sweeps and attacks. Okay, there are some things, but they're not very powerful. What I normally want to do is sit up to butterfly guard. Watch here, I'm going to shrimp up and I'm going to go to my butterfly guard. And when I sit up here, I can arm drag and I can use all those powerful butterfly guard attacks. Okay, but when I'm flat on my back, there's not that many attacks I can do. So that's why a lot of times when you go to butterfly guard, your opponent on top of you will try to put you on your back. Okay, now here's what we were taught to do 10, 15 years ago. When somebody puts you on your back, when you're playing butterfly guard and somebody pins you on your back, go to the pendulum sweep. This is what they used to teach us. Grab the tricep, slide your arm in, put your shin across his hips here, slide your right arm in behind his knee, and now go for the pendulum sweep. Straighten out your legs a little, bump him over, and do the pendulum sweep. Now, this works okay with the gi. I'm not crazy about this move, even with the gi. But without the gi, it's just really weak. Why? Because the grip on the triceps are very weak. My opponent could always strip his arm free, stuff the knee, and establish side control. That's not the move we're looking for anymore, okay? So watch what I'm going to do. When my opponent's pressure passing, he's forcing me on my back. Watch what I'm going to do. I'm going to switch my hooks. My left leg is now going to be on the right side of my body, and my right leg is going to go to the left side of my body. I'm going to give you guys another view of this very shortly. Once I've crossed my ankles here like this, I'm gonna pull on his tricep and climb up on my shoulder. Watch this here. I'm gonna lift my hips off the ground. I'm gonna bridge up, lifting my hips off the ground, pulling on his tricep. And watch here, once I have my legs over his back, I'm gonna shrimp forward on my shoulders. Watch how I shrimp forward here. I'm gonna grab my own ankle, and now he's in a really dangerous situation. Notice when I do all this, I also use my right arm here. Notice my right arm is blocking his leg, so he doesn't step over my head. I do not want to allow him to use this leg right here to step over my head, okay? So here I close my triangle, and then from there I'm gonna sweep and get on top, okay? So before that, I'm gonna give you guys a good view of the hooks. Watch here, as I switch my hooks, watch this, this is the back view, okay? So now my opponent cannot pass to the right. He cannot pass to the right because of this hook, and he cannot pass to the left because of this hook, okay? He cannot pressure forward either one of these arrows he chooses. If he goes to my right, I can put him in a triangle. If he goes to the left, I can put him in a triangle. And of course, if he goes up forward here, he's gonna be put into a triangle. His only good option is to retreat back, okay? If he retreats back here, it's his only good option. And if he does retreat back, what's gonna happen is I'm gonna go to my butterfly guard, which is what I wanted in the first place. Okay, now as you can see here, I have a lot of space between me and my opponent. My knees are not in my chest. I'm doing it this way so you guys can get a good view. When you see me do it live, you'll see, or while you're doing it live, you'll see that our knees are in our chest and the legs are really tight. They're really being smothered. Why? Because this takes some commitment on my opponent. If my opponent is not pressuring forward, I'll just sit up to my butterfly guard, okay? There's no need for me to go chasing the triangle because he'll just sprawl away and knock my legs down out of the way. Okay, so here, this is just for a good camera view, for you guys to get a good look at what my legs are doing. Now, once my legs are in position, watch what I'm going to do. I'm going to prop up on my shoulder. I'm going to wrap my legs around his back. I'm going to pull my head forward. I'm going to shrimp my head forward, grab on my own shin, lock in the triangle. And from there, watch what I did. I propped on my elbow here. Let me rewind it just a little bit. I'm on my elbow, and from my elbow, I'm going to prop up to my hand, and watch this. Once I'm on my hand, the sweep is just really easy for me to do. My opponent on his right side here, he has no base. As you can see, his arm is trapped completely with my triangle. What I'm going to do is I'm going to lift my hips up off the ground, and drive them right into this gap, exactly where he has no base. And what that's going to do is that's going to force him to roll. He'll have no choice but to roll. Once he rolls over, it's just me and his arm. His arm now is staring me in the face. And I have all sorts of attacks I can do. I'm not going to be covering them in this video because that would be way too long of a video. But a lot of you know these already do know these attacks. I'm going to scrape here. I'm going to do a wrist lock. If the wrist lock fails, I have the far side Kimura. Put my hand behind my neck, far side Kimura. And of course, I have the near side Kimura, which is probably the most effective of all the holds. Here, I'm going to get back to side control and start cranking his arm behind his neck. Now here's my opponent here. I'm playing butterfly guard. He's not allowing me to play butterfly guard. He's smash passing me here. He's pinning me on my back. As soon as he starts to pin me on my back, watch how I switch my hooks here. And here my opponent, once I switch my hooks, you see my knees are in my chest. Just like I was saying, it's going to be tight. You know, when I feel my opponent's putting a lot of pressure, this hook here is preventing him from passing to the right. The other hook you can't see is preventing him from passing to the left. And of course, he cannot smash through my legs. My legs are crossed underneath him. He won't be able to smash. The right answer for him would be to move back now. Okay, alleviate the pressure off me. And if he does that, what I'm going to do is I'm going to sit up to butterfly guard and start doing my arm drags, etc., butterfly guard sweeps. But here my opponent, you know, he stays heavy. He keeps the pressure. He's trying to keep me on my back. Watch how I'm controlling the triceps. Watch how my hips come off the ground. Once my hips come off the ground, he's realized it's too late. Watch how I'm going to try to reach for my foot here. Actually, I didn't need to reach my foot. And right here, I'm going to prop up to my elbow eventually, prop up to my hand. Once I do prop up to my elbow and here I'm taking my sweet time, but once I do prop up, there's not much my opponent can do. I'm going to drive my hips forward. And sometimes when you get on top, the opponent on the bottom is very resisting. Watch what I'm going to do. I'm going to grab his ankle. Just grab his ankle and lift it up. Okay, so when I'm lifting the ankle up here, when I'm lifting the ankle up, it creates a tremendous of downward pressure here. See, I'm sprawling my hips forward just a little bit, and I'll just hold this ankle up until he just collapses. I mean, I'm pushing my hips forward here, and the pressure is all on this side of his shoulder here. There's nothing for him to base with. He's just using he's using his knee here to defend himself, but also he's using his abs and his torque here. He's really working his abs really tight. He's fatiguing himself. Eventually, he's going to crumble, and when he does, it's just going to be me and his arm. And I'm going to find a way to Kimura him one way or another. Okay. Now, sometimes the Kimura takes a while to finish, but the good news is he's really trapped. There's not many things he could do to escape this inverted triangle. And eventually you will work your way to that Kimura. All right, guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. Please like, share, comment, all that good stuff. And I'll see you in the next one. Thank you.
Bonjour, mon nom est Marc-Élie Toussaint, je suis entraîneur de sprint depuis 23 ans. Je travaille au niveau de la vitesse avec Georges Saint-Pierre depuis 4 ans. Je viens de tester le Tim Tam, c'est le meilleur instrument au niveau du relâchement musculaire que j'ai testé de toute ma carrière. Je le recommande à tous.
When you train a lot, you get tight. The best way to loosen up your muscle is the Tim Tam.
Hi, I'm Jean Saint-Pierre. I'm using the Tim Tam machine after my training to help me with my recovery.